Okay, now I have everything level. Everything is level. Now, all I have left to do is the final, I call it final two sheets. That will cover from this edge to the edge on the back, from this edge to the seam edge in the back. One big cloth, then another big cloth. Grind to shape, prime and paint. This was rotten right through. This was one of the pieces. We had a foam backer, a foam core, I should say, for the deck. Now it has NIDA board, a half inch, with 1, 2, 3, 4, or probably about 15 layers of biaxial and top strand alternated. I don't know what else will disappear on this boat, but this piece should last for quite a while. It's getting cloudy. I don't know how much more I'm going to get done, but at least I'll get the shape of my cloth cut, which I have under there folded, ready to shape. Clouds are moving in really fast. Here in the Cayman Islands, this time of year with the shifting winds, it's unpredictable. But nice, cool, and refreshing. And Tugan Annie rises from the depths. Welcome back from Davey Jones Locker, baby. Soon you'll be back out in the high seas. I just got to cut off the edge of my mast, 6 inches. I have a pedestal to raise that mount for that bracket up the difference that I cut off from the mast. So all my rigging and gear stays at the same original heights. My two hands only. Take her out of the water. My buddy's crane is gonna come. I'm gonna put it right there. And paint the bottom, paint the top deck, and then put it right back in the water right there. New ropes, new riggings, new spreaders. It's time to go sailing. Seas again. Two banani. Can't keep her down. Yeah, I might get my accent coming back, you know. It's time to get my American on, man. Hi, Annie. How you doing? See you tomorrow. Okay, girl, I'm gonna wrap you up now. Put you to bed. We'll finish off. Next step. Needs to have the edges ground out, like right in here, and then I'll re-grind my groove and balance off all the areas, or level off I should say. Same thing here, ground out any air pockets, grind back out the groove tomorrow. Make smooth, put the just a little bit of finishing putty, and we can gel coat. The rest of the boat, of course, needs now for the sanding to come along, freshen up this gel coat, and then reapply. We'll be taking the boat out of the water and putting it right here on the left side of that mast so that I can sand and depocket the bottom, the hull, and repaint. But here we are, finally done, or done-er. But just that one area you think would be easy, over an inch deep, and with all kind of complex curves and turns. At a high spot there, I caught that in time. I cut out that piece of cloth. Now we'll sand smooth. Everything is pretty much equal. Friends all around, beeping their horns, saying hello, watching me out here suffer in this hot sun all day with a old sunken boat. But Tuga Nanny rides the game. She rides the waves. What a beautiful hull. Inside is really, really nice and spacious. Inside is well along. She was victimized by Hurricane Ivan, now Hurricane Tyrone.